Welcome to Green Living. Notice anything different? Well, yes, I am surrounded by a number of different bottles. That's because today we're going to be showing you some design-based crafts on how to upcycle these handy objects. Now, bottles, whether they're glass or plastic, take an enormous amount of time and resources to produce, and even more to dispose of.
In fact, almost 250,000 plastic bottles are dumped in landfills every hour. Now, while glass bottles are significantly better for the environment due to its ease of recyclability, they still pose a problem due to the fact that they usually end up in landfills and do not decompose at all. Yet we use bottles all the time, as containers for water or soda or detergents, and we go through numerous bottles every day with little thought to how they will be disposed of.
Today on Green Living, we'll show you how to upcycle, not dispose, of all the empty bottles you probably have lying around your house. Now, while we all care about doing our share in keeping the planet healthy, we also care about design aesthetics. Why upcycle and make a shoddy vase when you can make it a work of art? We'll show you how when we come back. I'm Paolo Abrera, and this is Green Living.
In a way, everything is connected, and through the threads that I use, or the pins, accumulated pins, that you can imagine stretching out to the infinite, all these elements that inspired me are very linked together. Hi, my name is Olivia D'Aboville. I'm a textile sculptor. I'm half Filipino, half French, and I studied in Paris textile design. I think what makes me a unique artist is really the techniques that I use to create my woven three-dimensional forms. I use textile techniques, whether it's tapestry, embroidery, threading, to create shapes, different shapes and sizes. The materials that I use are mostly recycled. It goes from plastic bottles to plastic bags, pins also. I do a lot of recycling and upcycling of different materials. So I really start with an existing object that is mass-produced, and then I will accumulate it and transform it into something new. My work is usually inspired by nature, and more particularly the ocean. Whether it's the sea creatures or the water, the movement, the light that goes through the water, the corals also, their organic shapes and their colors. So all of those underwater elements. I wish to contribute to the art industry here in my own way. So I really recycle materials, and those materials are actually the ones that end up in the sea, so the plastics, for example. So I hope that it inspires people to be more conscious of their lifestyle. We all have a role to play, and especially in a beautiful country such as ours, surrounded by sea.
Having been exposed to the wonders of the sea at an early age, Olivia's artworks now reflect her love and respect for Mother Nature.
Since I was really young, my parents would bring us to Puerto Galera. So I really grew up with the sea. Going snorkeling, and I passed my paddy license when I was 13, so I was really, really small, and I still remember. I remember when I was really young, in Long Beach, for example, we didn't need to go to swim so far to see amazing fish and biodiversity and corals, different colors. And over the years, I would notice that you had to swim further away from the shores to see those biodiversity. And this happened in all those various locations, that the corals would eventually, you know, die. So it really struck me, and I feel quite responsible because I live in Puerto Galera, and I don't want Puerto Galera to lose all the beautiful corals that we're known for. Through my work, I try to convey a message that you know, you have to respect nature. Nature is so beautiful, it's so abundant, but We have a responsibility to keep it that way, or else the future generations will not be able to witness it.
D'Aboville's love for the sea is evident in her textile sculptures, which have been exhibited here and abroad.
My most significant exhibit is probably the one at Ayala Museum that I had 3 years ago, called Chasm of Fantasies. The art pieces that I showed at Chasm of Fantasies were all inspired by the deep sea creatures. So I really wanted to give this sense of the experience that I have when I dive. In March 2012, I was really fortunate to exhibit in Singapore for the iLight Festival. We were 30 international artists, so I was representing the Philippines. And my concept was a coral garden. And basically I had 36 sculptures that were lit with LED lights. And all these sculptures were made of recycled cocktail stirrers that I would collect from different bars here in the Philippines, in Manila.
But Olivia's skill is not only limited to creating sculptures. She also creates installation art.
I ventured in the design industry in 2012 when Kenneth Kabanpue invited me to join his Hive team. And so I designed a lamp called Anemone. And it had this commercial look to it. We have different variations. We have one for the wall, we have a floor lamp, and a table lamp. Since last year, I was very fortunate that Saitem asked me to join their young designers team. And they pair us with different Filipino manufacturers. And recently, I was able to collaborate with Tadeco, based in Davao. So I created a lamp which is made of abaca mixed with copper wire. So those are really their two signature materials. Hi, welcome to Altramondo Gallery in Greenbelt 5. This is my latest show, Sacred Geometry. For this exhibit, I've used mostly metal pins that I've upcycled. I've used, I guess, almost 20 kilos, so this is a lot of metal pins. For my show, Sacred Geometry, not only was I inspired by the sea creatures, such as the sea urchins, but I was also inspired by the connection that we have underwater with the cosmos. You have the stars of the sea, but you also have the big stars of the space, and the relationship between the infinitely big and the infinitely small, what you find in molecules or atoms. Which looked like solar systems. And through this exhibit, I tried to showcase that.
Staying true to her art, her love for nature is also reflected in her everyday life.
I try to be conscious of the waste that I produce. For example, if I go somewhere, I will bring my own thermos. I will bring my own bags instead of using plastic bags. If my art can inspire people to actually be more aware of their own responsibility. For example, I do a lot of recycling. So this message of recycling is very important to me. Actually, I think the statistics are that 70% of plastic waste actually end up in the sea. So that's a pretty striking figure. And I guess if everyone really understood that that role that they play, they could somehow help. I mean, everything starts with us, I guess. So through my work, since I use mostly textile techniques, this has another symbol to it. The fact that I use threads, everything is linked together. I think that everyone has to be conscious that what happens under the ocean will directly affect us. So the fact that everything is linked together is something that I want people to see in my work.
Welcome back to Green Living. Are you guys ready for some creative upcycling? Well, I know I'm pretty excited to see what we can turn out. So first up is our plastic stash.
As you can see, we have a few plastic bottles of different kinds. One milk bottle, one soda bottle, and a water bottle.
Today we're going to be recycling these three different bottles in three different new and exciting ways, all with keeping a very specific design aesthetic in mind.
The intention of sustainable design is to eliminate negative environmental impact completely through skillful, sensitive design. And by upcycling these bottles today, this is what we're trying to do. We just need a few household tools such as a sharp knife, a sharp pair of scissors, a pencil, a little duct tape, some sandpaper, and you're good to go. Let's start with the milk bottle. Here, we're going to make an attractive pencil holder. First, we trace out our cutting marks with a pencil or a pen. Then we use a sharp knife to poke our first hole, and then follow through with the scissors. After sanding the rough edges down, we have a nice attractive pencil holder. And as you can see, the stark white of the milk bottle provides a nice contrast to the colorful pencils inside. Green design. Now we take an empty liter bottle of soda and turn it into a hanging horizontal planter. We trace our cutting marks and slice out the unwanted part with a knife and a sharp pair of scissors. Then poke some holes for the water to pass through. Later, we transplant some soil and voila! Instant planter. Lastly, we'll tackle the lowly water bottle. This is the easiest project. All we do is poke 5 holes in a horizontal line at the base of the bottle. Attach it to a regular garden hose and boom, instant sprinkler.
Simple, dynamic, sustainable, and attractive. We've successfully upcycled 3 plastic bottles into 3 new products that actually contribute to our green footprint. I'll show you how to upcycle some glass bottles next after this great green feature.
City communing is the bane of our urban existence. Add traffic jams, cramped public transportation, and the heat, and what do we get? More private cars on the road and more fossil fuel burn. A businessman saw this as an opportunity to bring in a sustainable mode of public transportation.
Green Frog Zero Emission Transport was founded in order to provide the Filipino commuter environmentally responsible, comfortable, safe, and reliable mass transportation. We are doing this now with our pilot project in Makati. We have the first 2 buses rolling, and in about 3 months we will have another 8 buses on the M1 route, which goes from LRT Taft all the way to Kalayaan C5.
Living in the heart of the city means having to withstand the daunting number of people in the streets, but this actually made it easier for Philip to decide on the company's pilot project.
I moved back to the Philippines 5 years ago after living in Europe and in the US. And I was used to living in city centers and I took the buses. When I moved back, it was a big shock for me to take a bus and a jeepney. So one day I was sitting in a coffee shop with a friend of mine. I said, this is the Central Business District. We drew Buendia, Ayala, and I said, we should run environmentally responsible, comfortable, air-conditioned buses in the city center.
After realizing what needs to be done, Philip then revved up the drive towards eco-friendly transportation.
Makati at night has about 700,000 residents. During the day, the population of Makati grows to about 4 million. And a lot of those people use Buendia. I mean, we are helping a lot of commuters. We are helping them get to their work in a very comfortable and safe manner. The route right now is probably the busiest route in the Central Business District. It starts by LRT Taft before it on the Makati side, and it goes down Buendia. We cross Quirino Highway, we cross Pasong Tamo, Ayala, Makati Avenue, Paseo, we go over EDSA into Kalayaan, and on that side you have the fort on the right side, Makati on the left, then we go back on C5. Now if you look at that route, you pass through 3 train stations. You have the LRT Taft, you have PNR, and you have the MRT.
Green Frog operates hybrid buses in the city. Each bus has an electric motor which shares the workload of the diesel engine. The diesel engine itself is Euro 4 compliant, which uses a much cleaner diesel fuel. Regenerative brakes charge the motor's lithium batteries whenever the bus slows down. Not only does the system help the bus produce a smaller carbon footprint, it also gives the bus a higher fuel mileage rating. For Green Frog, the move to a greener transportation alternative is just as important as ensuring the commuter's comfort.
I went with the very first trip that day. 6 o'clock in the morning, we rolled out. The first four people came in, and they were smiling. You know, and the first thing I heard from one of the first four passengers was like, "This feels like Qatar." And I'm like, you know what? That just told me I'm doing the right thing here. People are feeling like, you know, they're getting first world transportation. I sat for the next 6 hours in the bus. I talked to the riders. Everybody, you know, everybody I talked to was very happy. It's more comfortable. It's air conditioned. It's cheaper than what they have right now. You know, you're getting something much better than what we have right now for less. I mean, what more do you want? So yung bus namin, low floor. So when you enter, madali pumasok dahil mababa. Pagpasok mo, eto na yung bayad kung cash ka. Ngayon, pwede kang bumili ng prepaid card. May load na 10 sakay. 120 pesos, tapos may 30 pesos deposit yung card. Eto, pagpasok mo dito, itatap mo lang sa machine. Babawasan na yan ng 12 pesos, tapos makikita mo yung load mo. Again, first thing you see when you enter, you have security cameras. There are 6 security cameras, one in front, one in the back, and 4 on the inside. And it is filming you 24 hours a day. The driver can also see you over here in the monitor. You have luggage racks, you have very comfortable seats, and then you have seating for the PWD, for the elderly and the pregnant women. And again, these are lowered for more comfort. These are actually painted yellow so you can see the safety bars. Exiting the bus is very simple. Press this.
Very comfortable and ano siya, parang amazing kasi this is how they do it in the first world country. Tapos nandito sa atin rin.
Masasabi ko lang sa ano, sa pasahero, mas comfortable sa bagay dito kasi nisiksikan at saka mas mura ang pamasahe.
We applied in the beginning for 3 routes. They granted us the first one, which is the Bundia to Kalayaan route. We are working on the second one, which is the Makati loop, and another one in Makati also. We would eventually like to have about 38 buses running in Makati itself. And eventually the first route, the M1, we would like to extend to Moa. Now we're working with the city of Pasay right now. I mean, they're very open to the idea of running all the way through Bundia up to Makapagal, all the way to Moa and back. We're also working with the city of Mandaluyong to open up a new hybrid bus route right there in the middle of their city. We'd eventually like to grow into the other cities also, like Quezon City, and we'd like to bring the hybrid buses to the other big cities like Cebu, Puerto Princesa, Davao, you know, and spread the use of environmentally responsible transportation that way.
But like the other eco-friendly alternatives, the push towards environmentally responsible transportation can only succeed with the help of the government.
I think the government should actually stop talking green and be green. You know, you want to promote environmentally responsible transportation? Give us tax incentives. You know, if you can't take out the VAT, I'm okay with that. You know, you take out the import duties at least. You know, that 15% helps. That will bring our costs down a lot. You know, we want to promote environmentally friendly transportation. And I think this is the way the government could actually put their money where their mouth is. Let's pass a law to promote hybrid buses. Let's pass a law to promote environmentally responsible transportation.
The road to an efficient and eco-friendly transport system in Metro Manila is a long and bumpy one, but the team behind Green Frog Buses hopes to make it a comfortable ride.
In 3 months, there'll be another 8 of this, which means eventually when I have 10 buses running on Bundia, there should be a bus in your bus stop every 10 minutes. At that point, stop taking your car. You know, you take the MRT, you take the LRT, you take the train in, get off, wait for our bus, and we'll bring you as close to your office as possible on Buendia. I mean, this is one way of alleviating pollution. It will alleviate traffic a lot.
Welcome back to Green Living. Now, as you can see, we've successfully completed our upcycled plastic bottle projects. And if you ask me, they look pretty nifty. So what do you say we up the game and work with some glass bottles? Now, because we're working with a much more dangerous material, safety has to come first, because we're about to engage in some glass cutting.
Using a homemade glass cutter like this one patterned after a YouTube project, we'll carefully cut these glass bottles. It can be anything from nifty glass to a flower vase. After a quick sanding down of the glass bottle's rough edges, as well as properly disposing of the unused parts, we have our new glass products.
From plastic to sustainable and aesthetically pleasing, from glass to class, we've got tons more ideas on design crafts for upcycled products, and I'm sure you guys have them too, so don't keep those ideas bottled up. For more tips on behind-the-scenes notes, you can log on to www.greenliving-tv.com or follow us on Twitter and like our Facebook page. I'll see you guys next week right here on Green Living. Take an enormous amount of energy and resources that you probably have lying around your house. Now, while we... into three new products that actually contribute to our green footprint. I'll show you how to upcycle some glass bottles. Completed our three plastic bottle upcycled project bottles of plastic projects. Plastic bottle upcycled from glass to class. We've got tons more ideas.
Ang bura pare.